week of liturgical music begins, I was asked to do a couple of pieces that I had written, more of a secular nature, but all of them have my faith and my belief within them. You know, child, that you
eyes, a world long forgotten. No one can quite begin to guess, except
all of his work on his compliments. Some of them weren't written out properly, and I just redo them. I appreciate the work he's done. To Davis plays all around town. Beautiful city. And finally, this is called Find a New Start. It's my song for spring. I'd like to dedicate it to my sister who's just moved back to Poland, Ohio, to be closer to my other sister, Connie. And so this is dedicated to Loretta. Find a New Start. Ooh.
Good evening.
Good evening.
I am Rich Cronobi here in St. Elizabeth. I welcome all of you, especially our visitors. We have people from all over for this concert. We have people from Columbus. Okay. We have people from Dayton area, or the eastern part of the state. Yeah, very good, very good. And how about northern state? Whether east or west? Yep, in second row in the back.
Youngstown.
Very good. How about out of the state? Outside of Ohio?
Out of state.
Excellent. So we know that Rino's music has been featured in all over, especially in Ohio. And we're very honored to have him, even though he's a neighbor from St. Peter's Church, that he's able to present his music here for us tonight. So you do have a program to follow along, and he will introduce that more as we get going. The group of singers here, I think we're just really going to have a blast. So I'm going to introduce to you Rino and Angelini.
Thank you.
back at St. Elizabeth's. I shouldn't do this, but I'm going to confess that I was watching an epic VHS tape. I'm 30 years younger right in this sanctuary. It's humbling. We are here to pray the beautiful liturgical year that we have in our church. And with that, it was expanded because there's the Matthew, Mark, and Luke that are all parallel gospels. We now have three cycles of readings, but they all go through that cycle of the church year, from Advent to Pentecost. Advent, Christmas, Epiphany, Baptism of the Lord, Ordinary Time, Ash Wednesday, Lent, Holy Week, Triduum, the most holy time of the year. The whole 50 days, we had 40 days of Lent, we top that with 50 days of Easter, and it culminates in Pentecost. But we're not done. We have to go then to Corpus Christi and Trinity, and of course then the full week. And this is what we're praying tonight. And in the next 2 pieces, we acknowledge first just our calendar. We begin and maybe end this evening thinking about school's beginning. And this next piece, Cross the Lord of Our Hands, was commissioned by the OCA when I first came to Columbus. And so we sang it back then, and then it ended up on coming to me. So let us prosper the work of our hands.
Oh,
cut through the start of the school year, beautiful for a funeral. Bernadette Farrell's Restless is the Heart is a beautiful symphony song.
Sticking with the calendar year, one of the easiest of our national holidays to celebrate the religious significance of is Thanksgiving, of course. The Eucharist, our Eucharist means giving thanks, Thanksgiving. And so it's just such an easy way to incorporate Psalm 67, which is the song for Thanksgiving Day, into this look at our beautiful liturgical year. And now we're just thinking about how Thanksgiving comes after the opening of school.
Thank you.
another wonderful poet wrote this one, William Hudson. I dedicated it to Holy Rosary St. John's Parish because the 30 years I was at St. Peter, for 35 years, we twinned with them as a sponsoring parish for some of the programs, and I dedicated it to Father Cassidy and Father Scullin and people of Holy Rosary St. John. This is, there's another beautiful setting of this, at least one that I know of, and it's called Some Children See.
Songs. Help me learn to
So, some good friends in the choir of our saxophonists weren't here for coming to me, and he's trying to get me to play it again. So I'm going to see how we go, and because we're starting Lent, and so he's going to, might have to give it up for it. But maybe. Anyone finds like a million of these picks that I lost? I love the song of Joel. I love the reading from Joel when we read it by now. Why should they say, on Ash Wednesday, speaking, among the peoples, where is their God? Blow the trumpet in Zion and sanctify the fast. Assemble the elders, gather children. And so, this is what came in. Why should they say among the people, where is their God?
Where is
includes not singing Alleluia during Lent, so mea culpa for this concert. And in Lent, we substitute Alleluia for translation of Alleluia. Alleluia means Hallelujah, praise Yahweh, praise the Lord. You're allowed to say that way. As a Jew, you cannot say the name of the Lord, so you say Adonai or Lord. So what do? We praise the Lord Jesus Christ and His glory instead of singing Hallelujah during Lent. And this is the gospel I mentioned for Lent.
Thank you.
what's called Palm Sunday and is now called Passion Sunday is dramatically pointed out in the contrast between the opening hymn, the processional palms, and the psalm. We skip the glory, we don't do any introductory writing, we go right to the psalm. And the contrast between that and this Psalm 22, my God, why have you abandoned me, is the paradox of that celebration, which is now called Passion Sunday.
Amazing person who can open up the scriptures in a way that I
find in few scholars. This is my God.
Reading, I've been away 3 years, it's one of the fourth or fifth readings.
songs, fun songs. I really enjoy it. This takes advantage of women's and men's voices, so can you give me a, just give me a D. Like the women sing, "Cause we long for running water." And the song is so hard to sing, I finally figured out the men should do this. I mean, "So my soul longs for you, my lord." Ladies. "Cause we long for running water." Hold that. Men. "So my soul longs for you, my lord."
"As a deer longs for running water."
So men. "So longs for you." Everyone on the women's part.
"As a deer longs for running water."
And a youth choir is for so please join us. You can listen the first time, okay? And then please join us.
Thank you.
So I'm standing at the altar at St. Rose Parish, and it's rehearsal for what we're going to do on Holy Saturday. And it's as though I see this text for the first time, and I just sang it. And I thought, I need a word. It's not that complicated. Please join us, but here's I Saw Water. I love this song because we use it after the readings in Psalm 42 and the homily. We renew our baptismal promises on Holy Saturday, and then the entire church is sprinkled with holy water as a reminder of our baptism. And that's what we sing. can't remember what Sunday of Easter it is, but it's either the fourth, and I can't remember what cycle of readings it is either. But this is the beautiful song that appears in the gospel. But I wrote it because it's the vigil gospel for the Feast of Saints Peter and Paul, and I was at St. Peter for 35 years. But I dedicated it to St. Peter. But the person who inspired it was the beloved Father Ron Atwood, who was priest there and homilist par excellence for 3 years, and a good friend for over 30. So I'd like to sing it for him, but dedicate it to his sister Bobby, who is here with us.
Thank you.
Please join in.
Beat my legs.
wonderful gentleman, David, Captain Mr. Cassidy, is sitting in the second pew. Okay, so we've arrived at Pentecost, and the song is Love of Life. Please join us.
Thank you.
cannot even join the fish line. I cannot even sing, so I cannot even then sing. So I avoided it. But I know some of my friends they did. I hope you did. But some of you came in the church, and I played a couple of songs, just some secular pieces, but they're always expressions of my faith, one way or the other. And this one that I'm going to do right now is an encore. Tim Davis played for me the pre-concert program, and he just spent some, just, I had some wonderful hours rehearsing with him.
So we're not going to end as we began.
You could if they asked for another encore, but just hang around. It's just already 9 o'clock and they didn't keep it. So this is this song. It's one of the songs that I never get to play anywhere, and I thought maybe I'd just share it with you. This is a very personal song. I actually wrote it during the Vietnam War.
9:15,
but I'd like to dedicate it to the high school kids that just experienced, once again, a horrible shooting in Florida. And I dedicate it to them. I feel in their youth I was reliving this experience, and I hope this somehow expresses my feelings about it and you can empathize. And I'd like to dedicate this also to Carol, for whom I first played it on her grandfather.
I'm still your friend.
Concert and the name of the CD of theirs. Thank you, Rino. Thank you.